Hello everyone, welcome back to Shane's 2021 video blogging journey. So we're sticking with semi-final one today and we are looking at Malta. So I'm really excited to listen to this. So last year, I keep saying this for a lot of songs, but I think it just highlights how much, let me take these out, these aren't necessary. I think it just highlights how much I loved 2020 and how gutted I was when they pulled the plug. Destiny was internally selected last year, which was a great call, and Malta's done that of late. So the last few years they've internally selected their artists and gone away, found, probably paid for fantastic songwriters to write a kind of a good Eurovision song. So last year Destiny gave us, I'm having to look at it, All of My Love, which was epic. I think because last year was so strong, I think some people kind of forgot about it. I think it would have done well. She would have knocked out the part performance. Man, that girl can sing live. I mean, obviously winner of Junior Eurovision, and she's got Eurovision experience. She was a backing singer for Chameleon. But regardless of that, I mean, being from the UK, I remember her on Britain's Got Talent. Like, she's got bundles of character. She's a joy to watch, both being herself and also being a performer and performing. So it was a no-brainer for Malta to give her a chance. Now she's a woman. To represent Malta at adult Eurovision. It was a no-brainer. They just had to obviously make sure that the song that they picked was suitable and matched her talent, because she's super talented. And for me last year, I think it did. And I think when a lot of people talk about their favourites last year, she's almost kind of forgotten. And it kind of, I won't say doesn't make any sense to me, because if I'm trying to think of my top 10 from 2020, I think Malta will make it, because that song was so strong. And I remember the first time hearing it, the music video was high budget, high production. The whole package, I just remember being like, well done, you've picked a good song. And she sings the hell out of that song, and it really showcases her vocals. And actually the sound of that song for me suited her, because sometimes artists basically are selected and then they're given the song, and then you think there's a disconnect between this artist and this song that they've been given. But I thought the song last year was perfect for Destiny. It really did kind of match my understanding of what her sound should be moving forward, because yeah, I'm not that familiar with a huge backlog, a discography from her. I mean, I only know her Junior Eurovision song. So obviously I'm advocating now, I'm not a Destiny fan evidently, if she has got loads of other material out there. But All of My Love, amazing, loved it. So huge expectations this year. I mean, they've got a year. I think Malta were quite quick saying Destiny has got the ticket again for 2021, which again, I've said in my previous videos, that's the way forward. Every broadcaster should have done that, given the artist from 2020 another go. And they had a year effectively. And I mean, Malta did take its sweet time. It was like one of the last songs that I remember being like, come on. So I have listened to this once. I mean, I love Eurovision fan. Of course, I will hear a song when it gets released. But as I've said in my previous videos, I've deliberately listened to it once and not put it on a kind of playlist, and had a kind of few weeks off listening to Eurovision songs. So this is a bit more of an authentic experience when I review and react. But Malta's is obviously a bit more clear in my mind, because it's only been released very recently. So I've had one listen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to listen to it again. So here we go. Malta 2021, Destiny with Me Casse. Now I need to just do something very quickly to this. Boom. Okay, so let's start that. Let's make that big. Okay, I haven't seen the video, by the way. Sorry, I should have disclaimed that. I've only heard the audio. So it seems already. Malta have invested in the music video. Just obviously the camera lens, that looks high budget. I mean, this music genre couldn't be further away from her entry last year. Oh, I'm glad they've given her an upbeat song. I was worried they were going to go for a ballad. Ah, do you know what? Her just natural, cool attitude is coming across through this song and this music video. I love her confidence. Those dancers are epic. Now, I wonder whether they'll stick with that very simple hand gesture choreography for Rotterdam. I mean, it's very simple, but effective. She looks amazing. They've really, Malta's put a lot of money behind this package. This song, I don't know the songwriters actually. Because the songwriters last year were big Eurovision songwriters. I mean, how can I, like, my shoulder's already going, right? I can't find the songwriters. Oh, I can. I'm not familiar with their name. Like, how can you not move to this song? She's such a captivating performer. And I don't want to use the word, like, sassy, because unless you explain to me, like, what that means in regards to this context, that can be misconstrued. But she just has, in a positive way, just presence. And her kind of attitude matches the kind of message of this song. And this, I'm glad they've put in a kind of moment where she can belt. And I like the backing singers here. This is very dramatic in a good way. This sounds really current, like kind of pop R&B, this bit here, like Ariana Grande. So I was a bit nervous when I heard that from a snippet that people said that there was like a 1920s jazzy vibe, because I got electro velvet in my head, and as being British, I think PTSD there. Ah, and then we've got this trumpets with a kind of real upbeat production right at the end. Wow, okay. That's, I mean, I don't want to state the obvious because I know I'm not stupid. I've looked at the betting odds and she's right up there. So I was expecting it to be awesome because for Malta to be like 1, 2, 3 in the betting order, like there has to be something pretty special. Like All of My Love was high last year, but it wasn't in the top 5. And that is one of the favorites. And now I can see why Malta have invested a lot in this entry, and that they've given Destiny a song where she can go and be bloody competitive, which is great because she deserves it. And if Malta, this is the best chance Malta have had, I don't want to say ever, well, possibly ever, no, in the last kind of 10 years of actually maybe creeping into the top 5, not creeping in, I mean, the quality of this song and Destiny as a performer, like this deserves and warrants a kind of top 3 placing. It's just obviously Malta's got an interesting track record. It's always good to look at a country's kind of statistics and their kind of their average, really. And you know, let's not kind of lie here. Malta's a small country, and small countries historically are slightly disadvantaged, I think, when it comes to all the votes added together. It can be harder, and they do have to send quality artists and quality songs to be within the mix. And, you know, it's Malta, all right? And Eurovision fans are always rooting for Malta just because of their attitude to the contest. They take it seriously, which I think any Eurovision fan loves, and every Eurovision fan I think has got a kind of small place in their heart for Malta, and is always kind of cheering it on. But it's not just going to be Eurovision fans this year. I think it's going to be anyone who listens to this song. I mean, that song wouldn't be misplaced on the radio in the UK, which again is crazy if you think the sort of songs that we've sent in the last few years. Like, it doesn't normally tend to represent our charts. But that is a really good song. It's instantly catchy. And when you get to the end of the 3 minutes, you think, oh, I want that to carry on. Because you're also captivated by her as a performer. This is amazing. I mean, this is a sure qualifier without a doubt. It's ending semi-final one, so it's in the best place to even win semi-final one and get a really good placing for the final. Because what I don't want is I don't want the producers to choose Malta to open up the final, because that happened with Chameleon. Her name escapes me now. I really hope that doesn't happen. Because obviously, you know, the sound of this song should open a show, right? If this opens it, you're just like, yes, boom, ready. But I think if it wins the semi-final, or kind of comes first or second, I don't think they will then, mind you, I don't know, Belgium, what's the pressure with Laura? I think that came like third or fourth in the semi-final and they still shoved that at the beginning. I think it's an honour and a privilege to go first, but I think you are basically sacrificing a victory if you go first, because we've got to listen to 26 songs. So I really hope this doesn't go first. There we go. So love it. I'm so glad it's such a different sound to last year. I mean, I will be honest, because it's going for a kind of high impact pop feel. If I over listen to this, I can imagine after a month, 2 months, parking it being like, that was pleasant, but I still listen to All of My Love. I still listen to that to this day. I have one playlist that I tend to use to and fro from work, and it's still on there. I take songs off from Eurovision, obviously, once I over listen to them, but I still listen to that song. I think because they have gone for high impact pop in your brain, I don't know whether longevity I'm going to like this as much as All of My Love, but this is much more competitive. At least with All of My Love, I was just like, this is going to do well. This could win. So this is exciting. This is very exciting. So let's see. Let's watch this space. Let's see if Malta can do what a lot of people think might be the impossible and take the trophy. Because, I mean, I'm listening to all the songs. I've been kind of saying Lithuania, as I've been listening through, Lithuania has kind of been my standout. But I think Malta's picked it. I think Malta's just picked it there. So that's been interesting. So those are my thoughts. Please let me know what your thoughts are. Please, in the chat, engage with anything that I've said, and I will try and get back to you. Please like the video. Please also support and subscribe my channel as I go through the Eurovision 2020, 2021 songs. Until next time, take care.